Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I have a question today from Joe. Joe sent us a question in via email. You're welcome to phone your question in via voicemail or Skype, or just drop me an email to any of the numbers on the screen. Joe's question is pretty interesting. He has a situation where he has several lines and the spot prices for those lines for each of 5 days. And as he gets a new spot price, for example, as he fills in the data for Thursday, he has to go through and change this formula showing the recent change. Now, I'm sure in Joe's data, he probably has more products than this, and they're probably not evenly spaced. And you can imagine it's a relative hassle to go through and change that formula. Instead of D2 minus C2, to now point to E2 minus D2. One day you're going to forget, report the wrong change. So the interesting solution to this uses a function called the offset function. The offset function, let's build one from scratch here. The offset function says start from a particular spot. So in this case, I'm going to start from the first column, A2. And it says to go down a number of rows. Well, I don't want to go up or down any rows, so I'm going to put a 0 for the number of rows. But I do want to move over a certain number of columns. In this case, the number of columns happens to be the number of columns that have data in B2 through F2. So there's a great function for that, the count function. I'm going to say count the number of values that I have today in B2 through F2. In this case, that's going to be 3. So this function is going to say start at A2, move down 0 rows, and move right 3 rows. Let's stop there and see what we get. You'll see that we get the $1.35. That's the most recent value in D. Now from that, I want to subtract another offset function. This time I'm going to start at A2 again, go 0 rows down, and do the exact same count, B2 to F2, but subtract 1 from it. So this time, instead of moving over 3 columns, I want to move over 2 columns. And you'll see that from $1.35 to $1.33 is a 2-cent change. I'll copy that formula down. And the beautiful thing about this formula now, as I get more data, for example, if I fill in the Thursday data, formula automatically updates. Now it's subtracting the $1.35 in D from the $1.39 in E. As I continue to fill in more data going down the page, the formula will automatically update to show the new results. Pretty slick using the offset function. Joe, thanks for sending in your question. If you have a question, please feel free to drop me a note and we'll get you on a future podcast.